Hello, and good morning, or good evening, depending on where you are. In Minecraft world, this is certainly evening. I've been living in this workshop, machinist workshop, for the past few Minecraft days. But it's still not safe outside the workshop, so I'm just gonna sleep it off. Yep, my whistling's still not up to par, up to snuff, up to what I appreciate when it comes to whistling. Now, I just realized that this bench here, so this bench is a simple workbench. And toss this rubber wood in here. That's made through Tinker's Construct. I'm going to grab some oak wood. So all it is your normal workbench. Just toss it back into your crafting table, and it becomes a crafting station. Just like that. The special thing about it is, if you leave stuff in it, that stuff stays in there. Your normal crafting table will not keep items. So this one's a little bit above and beyond those. It won't keep items in them, it'll just toss it out. It does act as an inventory, so if you are pumping things in and out of things with inventories, it will work that way. Now let's just see about that. Now that I've been talking about it. So we haven't done anything with this clockwork engine. And we're pretty much limited with the types of pipes and types of machines that we're using. So if I... Ooh, and you just start going already. So apparently these clockwork engines do not need a redstone signal. They'll just start pumping whenever they get something to pump. So let's just toss these in here. So those are, there we go. So that just spit right out. And the thing about the clockwork engine is, obviously it doesn't need an external fuel source. It does run out pretty quickly. As we saw last time, you would charge it by just right-clicking on the... this until it gets to red. It stops and it pumps faster the faster we go. So if I do that, there we go. Not particularly useful at this state, as far as I know. If you guys can think of anything we can do with this, they'll pump stuff out of chests and things. But that's not, I can't think of a use for that at the moment. Other than a slight small transfer area. Can I just do that? Because it wouldn't make... So if I put that in there, it's going to pump it out, and it's going to pump that into a chest. So I guess what I could do... What I'm thinking... I'm trying to think of what is useful, what I can do with that. There's no sort of switching. I can make no real sort of logistics pipe system. I'll have to think. I definitely will have to think. Along with that, what I definitely can do is... I am looking for a book. Not that type of book either. Not that book either. Just a plain old book. Because I wanted to keep the patterns that I was using. But I don't have that right now. Oh well, not a big deal. Just get a few sticks. Make a wooden gear. So this is going to be... Oh, jeez. It's your basic... Basic... Basic. No, not like that. Wrench. So this is your basic buildcraft wrench. Grab that stuff. And what it allows us to do is to switch around where pipes are pointing and... Really? I can't do that. Can't move you. What if I remove this? Huh. Oh, that puzzles me. I put that in there. There we go. It allows us to move around where the engines are pointing as well. So pipes have a directionality. You saw that here. So, you again. So I put stuff in here, iron in here, and I put tin ore in here. This way, with this fat part on this side, it'll pump stuff out of the chest. And on this side, assuming, there we go, it'll pump stuff out of the work table. Work table? Work table. So that's our little experiment with the clockwork engine. If we do wind it up too much, it may explode from what I understand. So we were not going to try that today. I just made one. I don't really want to spend the materials to get another one. So that is our focus on the clockwork engine. Which is actually a pretty neat engine, given that you don't need any external power to run it. Now today, I want to get a few more of these pistons. So that's easy enough. Redstone. And just have to get the pattern right. There we go. And I need much more wood than I have on me. And I just want to make a few pistons, not as many as we have there. Just enough to have hanging around the factory. Factory floor, workshop floor. I wonder if the wrench works on these. Oh, yes, it does. Okay. That's good. Kind of. Okay, so it depends on the surface you're pointing at. So I can't. It doesn't appear that I'm rotating, but I might even be. Not sure. Or you just don't point at that side of it. There we go. So you can rotate these, which is great. I might use these for some type of door system. Because as you can imagine, it'd be pretty useful. So we have something like that. And let's see. I know I have levers. And let's put it on here. So they both push it that way, pull back that way. And that's if that block gets a signal. That's that block there. I want to move it back a bit. So that... This is where these come in handy. Kind of. I want to rotate it the other way. Damn you. Oh, there we go. There we go. So I'm trying to work out what's the best way to get this guy a signal. Now, temporarily, we will give it a large whitestone brick. So that's going to push that out that way. And these aren't the type I want. Not to make a door, at least. This is going to be a simple door. It's not going to be terribly complicated. Let's put you guys on display. Put you guys in a chest and pick up the slimy ones. Yeah, see the extent? Now these are slime. Do I have no... No extra brick. Oh, there they are. Stone bricks. So, simple door. Like that. Obviously, the switch is only on one side. If I give it a switch on this side... Oh, that does stuff differently than I remember this working. I remember this not working if you had the switch on both sides. You could go in, but you couldn't close it. And that's one way to do it. One way to make a door there. We could use the, too much stuff in my inventory. We could use the single trigger, or the non-slimy pistons, if we wanted to. Don't think I will, because what we'd have to do is put pistons on this side and pistons on that side and find some way to control it from one control panel on either side. So, you come to the machinist workshop and it's like, oh dear! It's just a wall. Well, no, it's not. Turn that on, turn that off, and you're locked inside, nice and safe, and sleeping away the creepers. All right, well, that gives us a good base for the workshop. But as you can tell, I am probably going to want to do something more like this. Like that. Not like that. Take that away. So, it's going to be a wall like this, or a wall like this, on both sides. So like this. So to get in and out of here, you'd need to use the lever system. Thinking of applying that to something like this, but I want a larger system. So maybe a sticky pistons on both sides, so I could walk through. I prefer it to be actually three high, because there's a very good reason why I have my horse out here. It's that I couldn't get it inside without breaking through the wall, so I built a little shelter for him, and you don't have a saddle. You do not have a saddle. Interesting. I built a little shelter for this guy. Saddle him up. And it was all because, ow, I couldn't get in through the door. Too high. Ow. And I'm being hurt there because it's too low. Where is... Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Sorry, horse. Where is... Yep, there's your lead. I wonder what happened to all my other leads. Not a good sign. But, yeah, that was us playing with our sticky pistons. I want to head back to the village. Or to the outlier. Today. And... I was trying to think what our best way to get there would be on a horse. I don't think there actually is a good way to get there on a horse right now. Because if we're going on the outside... We are crossing over water, and water sucks for horses, as we saw a couple episodes ago. Oh, damn you. That block error again. Oh, wow. This is spreading, I think. The magical forest, I mean. It's definitely gone farther out. This is still tainted. But at this point here is magical forest. So where we plant this tree really does matter. It really does make a difference. Huh. Are there any slime tendrils up here? I haven't actually been in this area for a while. Because I felt that I had... Has that been on the entire time? Because I felt that... I'd taken care of the tendrils sufficiently earlier. I thought that, they'd be okay. And we're having more chunky... Goodness gracious. Maybe I can just drag him across the water. Alright, horse. Just want to get over there. You can swim fast enough, right? If you hear my cat in the background, he's wanting attention. He usually doesn't get up this early. Yes, it's early again, and yes, that was coffee if you've been listening very closely. One of you actually told me that you wake up at 3 a.m. So I'm like, oh, wow. I'm glad I don't get up that early. I guess I'm one of the lucky ones to have the choice. I'm assuming you get up at 3 a.m. not by choice, but by necessity. Unless you really like 3 a.m. I guess you could be an astronomer who wants early morning readings. Oh, my girlfriend used to be an astronomer, but that was mostly radio telescopes. Oh, damn it. Where'd my horse go? Where'd my lead go? Ah, blast. Blast in blazes. Okay, horses don't do mountains very well. Or water. Mountains and water, no. So, I know chocobo. suppose, because Whiskers and I had a nice... And he doesn't do too high, unless I can hit that. There we go. Oh, got out of there, finally. Unless I could hit the appropriate jumping height thing meter on the bottom. But yeah, horses definitely do not do water particularly well. We saw the trouble I was having with this guy and water, and I am trapped. Let's try this way. Find a little path here. That, no. Oh dear, no, God. That's not the way. Let's just go around this way and hope there's some path I can follow. That water's okay. That's water. Can I get up here? Trouble with horses. Ow. What was that? Go up this way. Go up some way. There we go. Okay, scaling mountains. Okay, where's my shovel? This has been kind of a catastrophe. There we go. Scaling mountains. Apparently he doesn't like that, it's too small. There we go, all right. We made it, and now we're probably going to fall to our death. Damn it, the other side of the mountain. It's not one side, it's the other. There we go, come on, a little bit more. We can do it, and we can remain alive. I assure you. All right. And we get sheep in our way, but... Oh well. And what's going on here? Aren't you moving? And pawns. We don't want pawns. This is the whole reason why we're going around here. Okay, so horses. They're cute. But they're no chocobos. Let's just get... Actually, why don't I just do this? Yes, guys, I'm here. So the thing about chocobos, and this guy hasn't grown up yet, I guess I haven't been in this area too much, is that they can't really jump. So you see this guy, he's just fluttering around here. No jumping ability whatsoever. At least not the blue chocobos. They also shed like crazy. And this guy, he's been with me for a while, but we've fallen quite some distance at some point in time. You know what? Let's not go that way. As long as we don't fall in a ravine, we'll be fine. This area is actually a bit of a pain, because it has all these holes. So for exploration, chocobos are great. Blue chocobos are even better for water. But they don't climb and they don't fall particularly well. So if you do hit a ravine like we did, so you didn't get that on camera, or I didn't get that on camera. But as you can see, I can actually swim with this guy, and he actually swims pretty damn fast. Have I been in this area? I must have been in this area. Just on a different side of it, because I don't remember that particular formation. I haven't been this way, though. Let's head out this way, see what we can see. So this is all the new terrain gen. Oh, and it's nighttime. Damn night. I don't have a bed on me. I can make a bed. Oops. Not a... A barricade, a bed. Thank you! Not a bed. Not a barricade, a crafting bench. And I need wool. Apparently it doesn't take chocobo feathers. Oh well. Ah, damn it. And I forgot. So many goof-ups today. Like that. Toss that out. Grab that. And we have a bed. Yes. Whiskers. I'm gonna take the bed with me. Yeah, I'll take that with me too. I usually like having a bed on me. And I think, let's actually do it. I'll actually be happy with a bedroll from Open Blocks. Because you just put it on yourself. I mentioned this last episode. Ooh. You are not doing too well, are you, Whiskers? All right, he's not going to survive one more fall. Or is that a she? Ooh, she's not going to survive one more fall. That's not good. That's not good because I need a female for the breeding, I think. Well, I don't know what that green chocobo is, so I need to have one male, one female, to breed up, with the, green chocobo to make, potentially, is it the white? Yeah, the white chocobo, which can both swim and climb, because green can climb, and blue can swim, so I think white can swim and climb, which is going to be a great exploration chocobo. Of course, I could just continue breeding chocobos until they do produce. Ooh, a jungle. Is that a jungle jungle? Ooh, I don't want to get stuck in quicksand. Is that a jungle jungle? Is this a real jungle? It's cats. Jungle. It's a real jungle. Awesome. I have to do some exploring in this area if I don't get stuck in too many trees. Yeah, I'm going to take this one back and set up an area for it to heal. And I'll show you guys that setup next episode. So this has been Mobius Rex for the Mobius Archives, doing a little bit of chocobo exploration and a little workshop menagering, definitely not menagerie in the workshop, a little secret-ish-esque door. That's not really a door, so villagers can't use it, and they don't treat it as a village door. That's an idea. And swimming with your mount. Stuff people with horses don't get. Alright, this is Mobius Rex for the Mobius Archives. Thank you very much for watching. If you like this episode, leave us a like and subscribe if you haven't yet. If you enjoy these episodes, we do Minecraft Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and Kerbal Space Program on Saturday, and we do put these out on a regular basis. Exactly. So, have a good day and a wonderful night. Bye-bye.